Once again this evening, I bring sincere greetings in the sweet and dear name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ.
നമുക്ക് പ്രിയങ്കരനായ കർത്താവായ യേശുക്രിസ്തുവിന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്കെല്ലാവർക്കും ആദ്യമായി വന്ദനം പറഞ്ഞുകൊള്ളട്ടെ.
The theme of our series of meeting is beholding Christ through John's eyes.
നമ്മുടെ ഈ യോഗ പരമ്പരയുടെ തീമായിട്ടിരിക്കുന്നത് കർത്താവിനെ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ക്രിസ്തുവിനെ യോഹന്നാന്റെ കണ്ണുകളിൽ കൂടെ ദർശിക്കുക എന്നുള്ളതാണ്.
And let me tell you at the outset, these are only some glimpses that we are able to touch in this series of meetings.
ee yoga paramparayil namukku ee vishayam sambandhichulla chala athyavashya karyangal adinte poramayulla chala karyangal mathram chindikkuvane samayamullu.
There is so much of depth in the word of God.
ee veda pusthakathil valare aazhathilulla karyangal undu.
May the Lord impress something very important this evening on your heart and my heart.
ningalde ende hrudayathil valare pradhanapetta oru karyam അത് ആഴമായി നമ്മുടെ ഹൃദയത്തിൽ പതിപ്പിക്കുവാൻ തക്കവണ്ണം കർത്താവ് ഇന്ന് പ്രസാദിക്കുമാറാകട്ടെ.
ബിഹോൾഡിംഗ് ക്രൈസ്റ്റ് ത്രൂ ജോൺസ് ഐസ്.
യോഹന്നാന്റെ കണ്ണുകളിൽ കൂടെ കർത്താവിനെ ക്രിസ്തുവിനെ ദർശിക്കുക.
വിൽ യു പ്ലീസ് ടേൺ വിത്ത് മീ ടു ഫസ്റ്റ് സാം വേഴ്സസ് 1 2 ആൻഡ് 3. സാം 1 വേഴ്സസ് 1 2 ആൻഡ് 3.
ഒന്നാം സങ്കീർത്തനം അതിന്റെ 1 2 3 വാക്യങ്ങൾ.
ബ്ലെസ്ഡ് ഈസ് ദ മാൻ ദാറ്റ് വാക്കത്ത് നോട്ട് ഇൻ ദ കൗൺസിൽ ഓഫ് ദി അൺഗോഡ്ലി, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper.
ഒന്നാം സങ്കീർത്തനത്തിന്റെ 1 2 3 വാക്യങ്ങൾ. ദുഷ്ടന്മാരുടെ ആലോചന പ്രകാരം നടക്കാതെയും പാപികളുടെ വഴിയിൽ നിൽക്കാതെയും പരിഹാസികളുടെ ഇരിപ്പിടത്തിൽ ഇരിക്കാതെയും യഹോവയുടെ ന്യായപ്രമാണത്തിൽ സന്തോഷിച്ച് അവൻ്റെ ന്യായപ്രമാണത്തെ രാപ്പകൾ ധ്യാനിക്കുന്നവൻ ഭാഗ്യവാൻ. അവൻ ആറ്റരികത്ത് നട്ടിരിക്കുന്നതും തക്ക കാലത്ത് ഫലം കായ്ക്കുന്നതും ഇല വാടാത്തതുമായ വൃക്ഷം പോലെ ഇരിക്കും. അവൻ ചെയ്യുന്നതൊക്കെയും സാധിക്കും.
ഹൂ ഇസ് ദിസ് ബ്ലെസ്ഡ് മാൻ?
ഈ ഭാഗ്യവാനായിരിക്കുന്ന മനുഷ്യൻ ആരാണ്?
Beautiful thoughts you can bring out from this psalm.
വളരെ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ട ചിന്തകൾ നമുക്ക് ഈ സങ്കീർത്തനത്തിൽ നിന്ന് കൊണ്ടുവരാൻ കഴിയും.
As a young believer I was always told this speaks about the Lord Jesus Christ.
ഒരു ചെറുപ്പക്കാരനായ വിശ്വാസിയായിരുന്ന കാലത്ത് ഞാൻ മനസ്സിലാക്കിയത് ഇത് കർത്താവായ യേശുക്രിസ്തുവിനെ കുറിച്ചാണ്.
For who could be a man like this man on earth, God man?
ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു മനുഷ്യൻ ഈ ലോകത്തിൽ
Who walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful, whose delight is in the law of the Lord,
തന്റെ ന്യായപ്രമാണത്തിൽ സന്തോഷിച്ച്
and in it he meditate day and night.
രാവും പകലും രാപ്പകൽ ധ്യാനിക്കുന്നവൻ.
And whatsoever he doeth shall prosper.
അവൻ ചെയ്യുന്നതൊക്കെയും സാധിക്കും.
I appreciated my senior brother who told me that this speaks about the Lord Jesus Christ alone.
കർത്താവായ യേശുക്രിസ്തുവിനെ കുറിച്ച് മാത്രമായിട്ട് ഇത് പറയുന്നു എന്ന് എന്നെ പറഞ്ഞു മനസ്സിലാക്കിയതായ പ്രായമുള്ള സഹോദരന്മാരോട് എനിക്ക് ബഹുമാനമുണ്ട്.
But I always had a curiosity, how does this speak about the Lord Jesus?
കർത്താവായ യേശുക്രിസ്തുവിനെ കുറിച്ച് എങ്ങനെയാണ് സംസാരിക്കുന്നത് അറിയാനുള്ള ഒരു വാഞ്ച എനിക്ക് ഉണ്ടായിട്ടുണ്ട്.
I have no difficulty in accepting what they said to me.
അവരോട് പറഞ്ഞ കാര്യം സ്വീകരിക്കാൻ എനിക്ക് പ്രയാസമില്ലായിരുന്നു.
But I wanted to find out from the Lord where I can find the person of the Lord Jesus Christ as the blessed man.
കർത്താവായ യേശുക്രിസ്തു അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ടവൻ എന്ന് പറയത്തക്കൊണ്ടോ അത് എങ്ങനെയാണെന്ന് മനസ്സിലാക്കുവാനുള്ള അതിയായ താല്പര്യം എനിക്കുണ്ടായി.
The whole thing is put up in one sentence there.
സകല കാര്യങ്ങളും കൂടെ ഒരുമിച്ച് ഒറ്റ വാചകത്തിൽ ഒരു വാക്യത്തിൽ ഉൾക്കൊള്ളിച്ചിരിക്കുകയാണ്.
The picture of the blessed man is given in verse 3.
ആ മൂന്നാം വാക്യത്തിൽ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ടവൻ ഭാഗ്യവാനായിരിക്കുന്ന മനുഷ്യന്റെ കാര്യം അവിടെ രേഖപ്പെടുത്തിയിരിക്കുകയാണ്.
It is said there that for he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water.
വെള്ളത്തിനരികെ നദിക്കരികെ നട്ടിരിക്കുന്നതായ ഒരു ഒരു മരം പോലെ അതായത് വൃക്ഷം പോലെ ആയിരിക്കുന്നതാണ് വായിക്കുന്നത്.
So blessed man is compared with a tree.
അപ്പോൾ നാം കാണുന്നത് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ടവൻ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഭാഗ്യവാനായിരിക്കുന്ന മനുഷ്യൻ ഒരു മരത്തോടാണ് അവിടെ താരതമ്യപ്പെടുത്തിയിരിക്കുന്നത്.
A tree planted by the rivers of water.
അവിടെ വെള്ളത്തിനരികെ നട്ടിരിക്കുന്ന ഒരു മരം.
Which bringeth forth its fruits in due season.
അതിന്റെ തക്ക സമയത്ത് ഫലം കായ്ക്കുന്ന മരം.
Its leaf never withers.
അവന്റെ ഇല വാടുന്നില്ല.
And whatsoever he doeth, he prospereth.
അവൻ ചെയ്യുന്നതൊക്കെയും സാധിക്കും, അതൊക്കെ ഏറ്റവും ഭംഗിയായി നടക്കും.
With that same note, yesterday we closed our message. Same thing Apostle Paul desired for a child of God. For the child of God. In 1 Corinthians 15:58 he wrote like this. My beloved brethren, abound in the work of the Lord. Be steadfast. Be unmovable. Abounding in the work of the Lord. For you know, knowing that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. So here is that blessed man. As a tree planted by the rivers of water. If you notice in verse 3, if it is tree, it should be mentioned or referred to as it, but it is referred as he.
സാധാരണയെങ്കിലും മരത്തെ ഒരു മരത്തെ കുറിച്ച് നാം പറയുമ്പോൾ ഇതിനെ എന്നാണ് നാം പറയേണ്ടത് എന്നാൽ ഒരാളെ അഭിസംബോധന ചെയ്യുന്ന വിധത്തിലാണ് ഇവിടെ ഇത് പറഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്നത്
സോ ദ ബ്ലെസ്ഡ് മാൻ ഈസ് കമ്പയർഡ് വിത്ത് എ ട്രീ
അവൻ ഒരു അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ട മനുഷ്യനെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം ഒരു മരത്തോടാണ് അദ്ദേഹം താരതമ്യപ്പെടുത്തിയിരിക്കുന്നത്
ഇമ്മീഡിയറ്റ്ലി ഐ തിങ്ക് അബൌട്ട് ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് മാൻ ആദം
ഉടനെ തന്നെ ഞാൻ ആദാമിനെ കുറിച്ച് ചിന്തിച്ചു
ആദം ഈസ് അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ത്രീ തിങ്സ്
ആദാമിനെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം മൂന്ന് കാര്യത്തോട് താൻ ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിരിക്കുന്നു
ഹി അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് എ ഗാർഡൻ
ഒരു തോട്ടത്തോട് താൻ ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിരിക്കുന്നു
ആഡം ഈസ് അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് എ റിവർ
ഒരു നദിയോട് താൻ ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിരിക്കുന്നു
ആൻഡ് ഹീസ് അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് എ ട്രീ
ഒരു മരത്തോടും താൻ ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടിരിക്കുന്നു
മേബി യു കൻ റീഡ് ഇൻ ജനസിസ് ചാപ്റ്റർ 2
ഉൽപ്പത്തി പുസ്തകം രണ്ടാം അധ്യായം
ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് വേഴ്സ് 8 9 ആൻഡ് 10
അതിന്റെ എട്ടും ഒൻപതും വാക്യങ്ങൾ വായിക്കാം
ആൻഡ് ദ ലോർഡ് ഗോഡ് പ്ലാന്റഡ് എ ഗാർഡൻ ഈസ്റ്റ്വേർഡ് ഇൻ എഡൻ ആൻഡ് ദേർ ഹി പുട്ട് ദ മാൻ ഹൂം ഹി ഹാഡ് ഫോംഡ് And out of the ground made the Lord God to grow every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food, the tree of life also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And a river went out of Eden to water the garden, and from thence it was parted and became into four heads.
ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു തോട്ടമുണ്ടാക്കി താൻ സൃഷ്ടിച്ച മനുഷ്യനെ എവിടെയാക്കി കാണാൻ ഭംഗിയുള്ളതും തിന്മാൻ നല്ല ഫലമുള്ളതുമായ ഓരോ വൃക്ഷങ്ങളും തോട്ടത്തിന്റെ നടുവിൽ ജീവവൃക്ഷവും നന്മതിന്മകളെ കുറിച്ചുള്ള അറിവിന്റെ വൃക്ഷവും യഹോവ ദൈവം നിലത്തുനിന്ന് മുളപ്പിച്ചു
ത്രീ തിങ്സ് ആർ സ്പോക്കൻ ദേർ
മൂന്ന് കാര്യങ്ങൾ
രേഖപ്പെടുത്തിയിട്ടുണ്ട് നോട്ടീസ് ഫസ്റ്റ് മാൻ വാസ് അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് എ ഗാർഡൻ വിത്ത് എ റിവർ ആൻഡ് എ ട്രീ
നാം കാണുന്ന അവിടെ തോട്ടത്തെ കുറിച്ച് കാണുന്നു അതുപോലെ നദിയെ കുറിച്ച് കാണുന്നു മരത്തെ കുറിച്ച് കാണുന്നു
ആൻഡ് വി റീഡ് ഹി ഫെയിൽഡ് ഇൻ ഹിസ് ടെസ്റ്റ് ദേർ
അവിടെയുള്ള തന്റെ ആ പരിശോധനയിൽ താൻ തോറ്റുപോയി എന്ന് കാണുവാൻ കഴിയും
ഐ തിങ്ക് ഓഫ് ദി സെക്കൻഡ് മാൻ
രണ്ടാമത്തെ മനുഷ്യനെ കുറിച്ച് ഞാൻ ചിന്തിക്കുകയാണ്
ഹി ഈസ് റെഫേർഡ് ടു ആസ് ലാസ്റ്റ് ആദം
അവൻ ഒന്നാമത്തെ അവസാനത്തെ ആദാമായിട്ടാണ് അറിയപ്പെടുന്നത്
ഡിഡ് യു നോട്ടീസ് ഇൻ ദി സ്ക്രിപ്ചർ ദാറ്റ് ഹി ഈസ് ഓൾസോ അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് എ ഗാർഡൻ
ആ രണ്ടാമത്തെ ആദാമിനെ കുറിച്ച് സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം അവൻ
He also is associated with a river. And he is also associated with a tree. And what a garden that was. This time it was not Garden of Eden. This was Garden of Gethsemane. This was not that river which break into four heads watering the whole garden. In his case it was a river Jordan.
യോർദാൻ നദിയാണ്
ദിസ് വാസ് നോട്ട് ദ ട്രീ ഓഫ് നോളജ് ഓഫ് ഗുഡ് ആൻഡ് ഈവിൽ
ആ നന്മതിന്മകളെ തിരിച്ചറിയുന്നതിനുള്ള മരമല്ല
ഇറ്റ് വാസ് എ ട്രീ ഓൺ വിച്ച് ഹി വാസ് becoming a curse for us
namukku vendi or shavamaayi thiruna aa marathe marathine kurishiniyaanu namukku kaanuvan kayunnu
but in all these things he the second man the last adam the lord jesus christ is seen to be victorious
ennal ella kaalangalilum avasaanatha manushanaya kathava yesu christu sagalathilum vijayayi ennu kaanuvan kayunnu
we are talking about the blessed man
aa nammala bhagyamaaya manushane kurichu parayaa
for he is picturized in the scripture as a tree planted by the rivers of water
adik valathinege nadappu nattu ായ ഒരു മരമായിട്ടാണ് അതിനോട് കാണുന്നത്
സോ വി ഹാവ് ത്രീ തിങ്സ് അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ഫസ്റ്റ് മാൻ
അപ്പൊ ആദ്യ മനുഷ്യനെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം മൂന്ന് കാര്യങ്ങൾ കാണുന്നു
ആൻഡ് ഹി ഫെയിൽഡ് ഇൻ റിഗാർഡ്സ് ടു ദാറ്റ്
അത് സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം താൻ തോറ്റുപോയി
സെയിം തിങ്സ് ആർ അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് ഇൻ ദ ലൈഫ് ഓഫ് ദ സെക്കൻഡ് മാൻ
അതേ കാര്യങ്ങൾ തന്നെയാണ് രണ്ടാമത്തെ
And he is victorious in it. My dear brother and sister, it is that privilege given to this Apostle John to trace the path of the Lord Jesus Christ, the blessed man. It is John who paints that delightful picture of the Lord Jesus Christ as a tree planted by the rivers of water. You know, until when? Until he brings every one of us to another garden, another river, and another tree in book of Revelation chapter
22.
So from Genesis to Revelation, you have one thought running through the scripture. What a garden that will be. What a river of life that will be. What a tree of life that will be. And it is John, let me repeat again, who traces the path of this blessed man, whom if we follow, are led to that beautiful three things in our lives. At each step of the Lord Jesus Christ, John was observing very closely. A preacher like me has a great desire in heart. With much prayer and preparation to give out to the audience the best that is possible and the most that is possible. So in this limited time that is before us, along with Apostle John, we are going to walk on that path of the Lord Jesus Christ, whom he says that as a tree planted by the rivers of water. For that is what is expected of a Christian. You can read in 1 John chapter 2 and verse 6. He who says he abides in him ought to walk in the same way in which he walked. If you say you are a Christian, if you say you are in the Lord Jesus Christ, he has ordained that path for us, that we may walk on the footsteps of the Lord Jesus. What is that steps of the Lord Jesus? Look at John, who is observing or beholding or bringing that picture of the Lord Jesus Christ before us in his gospel. Let us follow with him and trace the path of the Lord Jesus. And at the same time, let us examine our own lives. Are we walking as we ought to walk in this world for the Lord? So when John writes his gospel, I hope as a student of the scripture you know that the last book that is written is not the book of Revelation, but it's book of John. So here you have an old apostle, an experienced servant of God. Experienced servant of God. A man who was so close to the Lord. He was beloved of the Lord. He knew the Lord in and out. And he is helping us to see the Lord Jesus Christ, the blessed man, as a tree planted by the rivers of water. So when he opens the gospel, you can turn to John's gospel chapter 1 and look at verse 28. Where does John pray, place the Lord Jesus Christ first of all? He sees him by the river Jordan. I read John 1 and verse 28.
യോഹന്നാന്റെ സുവിശേഷം ഒന്നാം അധ്യായത്തിന്റെ 28-ാം വാക്യം.
These things were done in Bethbara beyond Jordan where John was baptizing.
ഇത് യോർദാനക്കരെ യോഹന്നാൻ സ്നാനം കഴിപ്പിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരുന്ന ബെഥാന്യയിൽ സംഭവിച്ചു.
So look at the Lord Jesus. As a tree planted by the rivers of water, first of all he is seen near the river Jordan. Why has he come there? He has come to take baptism. He did not need to take baptism.
But
he was born of a virgin, born under the law. He is supposed to be the end of the law. So we find him near River Jordan for the baptism. What a baptism that was. It is John who writes that first of all in this manner. Now if you read that verse properly, he is not giving any details about the baptism. Because the purpose of Gospel of John is different. But when we see the Lord Jesus near River Jordan, first picture is brought before us. For Jordan river was not an attractive river. It was a muddy river. It was a dirty river. Nothing good and nothing attractive about that river. And it is only John who opens his gospel that the Lord Jesus Christ, who came to his own and he was rejected. But that's what the first picture of John is seen in the life of the Lord Jesus. Nothing attractive and rejected by all people. Oh, what a sad state that we see about him. When you and I want to follow the Lord Jesus, don't expect a pat on your back. Probably you will be rejected. Probably you will suffer some loss. Thank God for that. That's how the life of the Lord Jesus Christ is brought before us. While he was not in a place where there was nothing attractive, and while there was everything fully rejecting him, brother, one thing happened there. One thing happened there. While you and I are being rejected and neglected and despised by the people, that same one thing should happen in your life and my life. What happened to Lord Jesus? In that critical situation of his life, heaven opened and shone its pleasure in his son. This is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. I want to ask a question first of all. While we live in this world, what would heaven speak about you and me? Look at your own life. Look at your own personal or family life. If heaven has to open, what will heaven speak about me? What am I concerned about? The appreciation from the world? Or the appreciation from the world above heaven? How many people are living just for the sake of living for the world? That's why we read in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 16. Wherefore he is not ashamed to be called their God. Is God ashamed of me today? Or is God happy about my life today? As far as the blessed man is concerned, in that rejected and despised situation, heaven has accepted him. My brother, my sister, don't be discouraged in this life. Endeavor for only one appreciation. One day that pat on the back is going to come to them who are faithful to the Lord. We long to hear that, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. You have been faithful in little things. Come and enter into the joy of my Father." So as John opens the gospel, he places him near the river Jordan. Rejected by all, but approved and accepted by heaven. If you trace the path of this blessed man and endeavor to walk the steps that he walked, this is what will happen to you and me. I repeat, let heaven have pleasure in your life and my life. Come to chapter 2 and verse 6. Chapter 2 and verse 6. John chapter 2 and verse 6. What do we see there? Now we have blessed man as a tree planted by the rivers of water. We see him near the 6 water pots. 6 water pots of stone. What stone? That speaks about the rigidity. The water pot speaks about the law and Moses. But one thing we find there, the water pots were empty. The law has so many things to speak about. It is rigid and hard and stubborn. But beloved, it is empty inside. It cannot give that which is needed for man and woman. Same picture we see outside. That's why the water pots are not 1 or 7, they are 6. For number 6 speaks about man. That's why we have hard-hearted men around us. Rigid and hard. But inside all empty. There is nothing there. But one thing happened there. When he was near those empty water pots, oh, there was a great miracle performed. Water was turned to wine. And a great blessing was seen in that wedding feast. Whenever you see Son of Man at some situations like this, that is what is expected of you and me in this world. Rigid and hard-hearted people. But he was a blessing to them. Are you a blessing to your places where God has kept you and me? Whenever you think of those water pots, there is one thing that we learn there. Because the Lord Jesus Christ was there, he brought sweetness to the place. What are you bringing to the places where God has kept you? Sweetness or bitterness? Fragrance or stinking? Unity or divisions? That itself will speak to you that you are not walking the path of the blessed man. So John is placing the Lord Jesus Christ and finding out him as a tree planted by the rivers of water in each of these chapters.
Ah,
How could he bring the sweetness there? Let me tell you, the secret is there itself. Just in the previous verse, what did his mother say to the servants? Whatsoever he saith, do it. That is the secret of bringing sweetness through our life. That is the secret of bringing fragrance through our life. Whatsoever he saith, do it. Many times I crossed this road here, and here I found in the church buildings, the cathedrals, they have a billboard outside, and the Sunday's message text will be given there. The theme of the message will be written there. While going through number of times in these roads here, I can tell you many themes that they have on this Sunday. But St. Mary's Cathedral here, the theme that they have for Sunday is follow the sun. Follow the sun. It is written, follow the sun, S-O-N. Oh, if only they really follow the sun. That's what the mother said here. Whatsoever he saith, do it. I said that is the secret to bring fragrance through our life. It is not whatsoever he saith, preach it. Whatsoever he saith, do it. We have many preachers. We have many preachings going on. But we have no practitioners. We don't have doers of the word of God. We lack models and example in our midst. If you just follow this text, whatsoever he saith, do it. Your life will become sweet. Your life will become fragrant. Just do it whatsoever he said. That is the secret of this passage here. So first you see the Lord Jesus Christ by River Jordan. And there you find his rejection. In chapter 2, you find him near the water pots. There you see the rigidity. But amidst all this, the Lord Jesus Christ made a big difference there. That's what the Lord has kept you and me in the places where he has kept beloved. But when you come to chapter 3, and in verse 5, you find the water is spoken for the regeneration. Except a man is born again, he or she shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Old man like Nicodemus couldn't understand. Lord, how can I be born again? Can I enter into my mother's womb and be born again? Then the Lord explained in verse 5. Except a man is born of water and spirit shall not see or enter into the kingdom of heaven. Again he is near the water. But it is the water of the word. The word of God. Oh, how much we need the washing of this water. Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 26 will tell you the same truth again. So we see water for regeneration there. We have seen chapter 1. We have seen chapter 2. We have seen chapter 3. Look at chapter 4. You will find this blessed man now placed near the well. Where is he? Near the well.
Avan kinarinte arige.
He is in a place of Samaria.
Ah, Samaria sthalathaanu.
Who was he? He was a Jew. Can a Jew go through Samaria? No. It is not possible. But blessed man is found by the well in
Samaria.
What a delightful picture of the Lord Jesus that is. I hope you know the location of Samaria. On one side you have Mount Gerizim. On other side you have Mount Ebal. This mountain have a great significance in the Old Testament. One speaks about the blessings, pronouncement of God's blessing. Other speaks about the pronouncement of God's curse. And in the midst of that, in Samaria, blessed man has gone. There is nothing withholding him. Is something withholding you to reach out to the unreached places? When you see the Lord Jesus Christ by the well there, you know what picture it is? It's a beautiful picture of the heavenly Joseph. Heavenly Joseph. Genesis chapter 49 and verse 22 will tell you that. Joseph is a fruitful bough. Even a fruitful bough by the well. Whose branches spread over the walls. I referred Genesis 49:22. So here you see the fulfillment of that in the person of the Lord Jesus. He is a fruitful bough. Even a fruitful bough by the well. And whose branches spread over the walls. There is no difference for him. There is no discrimination for him. Beloved, he has gone there just for one soul, you and I know that. What a going of the Lord Jesus Christ there. He is reaching out the unreached person. It's a very beautiful story there. Did I say story? If I say story, I should say sorry. It's a beautiful incident there. And the whole incident you can put in two words. Just put in two letters. It's all a quiz of SW. If I ask you this puzzle, if you can only solve this, you know this chapter 4 by heart. Think along with me. The S of the W came to SW. S of the W came to SW. S of the W came to SW.
S of the W came to SW.
Yeah. That's a good way. Met a SW. The S of the W came to SW. Met SW. Gave her SW. She became a SW. If you solve it along with me, it goes like this. The S of the W came to SW. The Savior of the world came to Sychar's well. He met SW. He met a Samaritan woman. She was a SW. She was a sinful woman. He gave her SW. He gave her some water. And she became a SW. A saved woman. And a SW. A spiritual woman. And a SW. A spiritual worshipper. And a SW. A soul winner. Did I say the whole thing to you? The S of the W came to SW, met SW, for she was SW. He gave her SW and she became an SW and SW and SW and SW. And what a story that is. And the whole thing is brought before us. Because the blessed man was there by the well. And what a blessing is seen in that chapter there. So in chapter 1, he is near River Jordan. Chapter 2, near 6 water pots. Chapter 3, water in regeneration. Chapter 4, he is by the well. Let me put chapter 4, 5 and 6 together. In chapter 4, you will find him near the well. In chapter 5, you will find him near a pool. In chapter 6, you will find near a sea. A blessed man. As a tree planted by the rivers of water. A well, a pool, and a sea. But compare that little more. The well was in Samaria. The pool was in Judea. And the sea was in Galilee. Oh, the places this blessed man reached out. Don't stop there. Look at chapter 4 again. For there you have a woman. In chapter 5 you have a man. And chapter 6 you have a multitude. Putting it all together. In chapter 4 you have a woman of Samaria. By the well. In chapter 4, chapter 5, you have a man in Bethsaida by the pool. But in chapter 6, you have a multitude by the Sea of Galilee. Beloved, the Lord, the blessed man, the Lord Jesus Christ was really fruitful every place and reaching out with a single or the multitude. John is tracing the path of this blessed man. When you read chapter 5, the key verse for chapter 5 is verse 7. What was that man for 38 years lying there, was crying? He had one cry. What was his cry? I have no man. I have no man to my help. That's what the cry of the people around us is. But he was standing before the man. When the man cried out, I have no man. Nobody to his help. Nobody to comfort him. Nobody to help him. Nobody to take him when the water is stirred up to put in the pool. 38 years have gone by. And the cry is, I have no man. Do you know my fellow believers? You just talk to your friend. Talk to your neighbor. They will have the same cry. I have no one. And he was a man in the gap. You and I, as a blessed man, if we follow his footsteps, are supposed to be men and women in the gap. For throughout the Gospel of John, you will always read this word, no. In chapter 2 and verse 3, you have no wine. Chapter 4 verse 17 will tell you, I have no husband. Chapter 5 and verse 7 will tell you, I have no man. Chapter 21 and verse 5 will tell you, I have no fish, we have no
fishes.
Life of man without God is always no lack of supply. But John says this blessed man was there. He didn't have to carry him to the pool. He did not to wait for the stirring of the water.
Oh,
what a miracle that was there. Beloved brother and sister, you can be a miracle in your places. If only you take your stand in the gap. Just putting your hand across somebody's shoulder. I still have the feel of putting that hand on my shoulder. I was just 19 year old. My parents have passed away. I was orphan. No father, no mother. No house, no property. No silver, no gold. I had a small job in the Indian Air Force. I was born again. I was in the assembly fellowship. Once the servant of the Lord sent me to some place to collect some Bible from there. I went to assembly in Thane in Mumbai. I cannot forget that day in my life. I went there. I collected the stock. There was an old uncle sitting there. He just genuinely inquired about me. I just said whatever was going through in my life. That elderly uncle, elder of that assembly then, now he's too old, not able to talk and walk properly. He put his hand across my shoulder. And he said, my son, don't be discouraged. Beloved, he gave me one verse on that day. For last 35 years, I am holding that verse
dear
to my
heart.
What is that verse? Psalm 68 and verse 5, he said. The father of the fatherless and the judge of the widows is in his holy habitation. God knows the state of an orphan. God knows the state of a widow. He becomes a succor and a help for them. Believe me, that word of that old uncle on that day onward has been my strength all through my life journey. How many around us, they need a kind of word like this? A phone call. A visit. Meeting somebody, talking to somebody, counseling somebody, praying for somebody. Have you become so self-occupied that you have no time for things of God? That you are not walking the way and the path of the blessed man. You see him by the well. You see him by the pool. But in chapter 6, you see him by the sea. What was he doing by the sea? That's the only miracle written in the Bible in all four Gospels. Feeding the 5,000. But don't stop there. Because only John highlights that situation. John highlights the weakness of that situation. For only John records three beautiful things there. I'm talking from John 6 and verse 9. When he talks about the lad, he was only a lad, a small boy. When he talks about the loaves, he talks about five barley loaves. When John writes about the two fishes, he writes that two small fishes. So look at the weakness of that situation. A small boy. Five barley loaves and two small fishes. Three things that speaks to us. A small boy is insignificant person. Barley was an inferior grain. And two small fishes was the insufficient supply. So you have three things there. And you can see the weakness of the situation. 5,000 without counting of women and children. How can these weak things bring a blessing? Insignificant person. Inferior grain. Insufficient supply of fishes. But when it has gone to the hands of the blessed man, the whole thing changed there. Oh, it was a great blessing. Everybody was fed sufficiently. And we read there that 12 baskets remained full. You know what we learned there? I learned a big lesson there. How many of us have thought that I am nothing? Because of the self-pity. Because of I cannot do this, I cannot do that attitude. How many good brothers and sisters, how many good families are not being used for the things of God? Let me assure you, God needs such weak things. When all your weakness, when all your sickness, when all your problems, when all your difficulties you hand over into His hands, He can make a miracle of your life even today. John is tracing the path of the blessed man. As a tree planted by the rivers of water. You see River Jordan. The rigidity there. Oh, you see the rejection there. Six water pots. The rigidity there. Word for regeneration. He is by the well. He is by the pool. He is by the sea. Oh, beautiful lessons you and I can learn from this. When you come to chapter 7, it is chapter full of water. For it was the Feast of Tabernacle they were celebrating. And the Feast of Tabernacle was celebrated with one remembrance. How God provided water out of rock for our forefathers. So each day the high priest would take the water and pour it down and say a few things. This happened on day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4. But when you come to verse 37, John 7 and verse 37, it was the last day, the final day. The rituals was going to come to an end. And the Lord was there every day. He was seeing all that was happening there. All emptiness was there. There was only a celebration there. But none of them was satisfied or quenched in their thirst of the soul. So in John 7:37, he cried out with a loud voice. If any man thirst, let him come unto me.
Oh,
what a call that was. They that come to the Lord Jesus Christ, out of them shall flow. Bible says, the waters of living, the rivers of living water. That's what happens in our lives, you know. In chapter 4, you find it's a beautiful comparison. In verse 7, the Lord is asking her water. Give me some drink. But in verse 15, the woman is asking him, give me some water. Situation is changed there. First the Lord asked her some water. But after some discussion, the woman is asking that water. And when he gave that water to her, her thirst was quenched in chapter 4. But in chapter 7, not only the quenching of the thirst, but flowing out of that. Until you come to chapter 13, and we find the water is being used for service. Chapter 4, 7 and 13 is a beautiful connection there. All over the Gospel of John, I see water, water, water everywhere. And the blessed man is as a tree planted by the rivers of water. Fruitful, abounding, successful in everything that he does. Only chapter 8 has no mention of water. Chapter 9 again you have the river Jordan. When you think of river Jordan, you remember that man? That man who was a leper. And what happened to him? He was told by a maid in his house, go to the servant of God and he will heal you. He went to the man of God. The man of God said, go and dip yourself 7 times in River Jordan. What did Naaman reply him? Naaman said, River Jordan? Why should I go to that dirty river Jordan? We have Abana and Purpur for us. Why should I go to river Jordan? Thank God there was a soldier there. Because of him he went there. He took a first dip. No change. No change. If he would have walked out of the water, he would have remained a leper. Second dip. Third dip. Fourth dip. Fifth dip. Sixth dip. No change. Walk out of the water. He would have come out as a leper. But thank God for one thing. Bible records, he took the seventh dip. And he came out, Bible says, his flesh as a small child. So in chapter 9 you have River Jordan again. But when you come to chapter 10, it's a beautiful reference again there. For in chapter chapter 10 verse 40 you have reference to Jordan. In chapter 9 you have the pool of Shiloh. In the pool in chapter 5 you can compare with pool in chapter
9.
Two things about God's work are mentioned there. In chapter 5, the pool, the Lord Jesus Christ did the miracle. But in chapter 9, the man was asked to go and wash in the pool of
Shiloh.
Chapter 5 speaks about the sovereignty of God. Chapter 9 speaks about the human responsibility. That's a beautiful blending in the scripture. That which God can do, God will do it for sure. But there are certain things God has asked us to do, and we are supposed to do that. So in chapter 10 you have River Jordan. But when you come to chapter 11, water is turned to tears. He looks to his right. Somebody is crying. He looks to his left. Somebody is crying. 4 days have passed and they are still crying. A death and bereavement was so painful for the family. That's why we see the blessed man in John 11 and verse 35. Jesus wept. When was it last that you had some tears for somebody, brother? It's easy for us to rejoice with them that rejoice, but weeping with them that weep. Very few are doing that today. Where are the tears in the assembly today? Where are the tears in the eyes of parents today? I am not talking about the tears of regret. What you were supposed to do, you did not do. And your children have gone wayward. I'm talking about those tears of our forefathers. They cried. And the Lord answered their prayer. Here are these two sisters crying. The Lord cried with them. He did not to cry. He was going to do the miracle. He was going to give the brother back to the sister. But he cried. Brother and sister, he cried. He knows the pain of your tears. He knows the values of our tears. Our tears are very precious to God. Never lose the tears. That speaks of our brokenness before God. Jesus wept, says the Bible. He cares for you. He loves you. He weeps for you. He is in pain for you. When you are persecuted, he says, I am persecuted. Only when you are walking the path of the blessed man. If you do not honor him, if you do not respect him, if you only take his word, his name in your mouth, his question will be one day for you. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not do the things which I say? They have no respect for God today. No reverence to God's word today. Look at the way they come, the way they sit, the way they interact. Everything is so displeasing in the sight of God. If you become a displeasing in the sight of God, it will be too late for you to return back. But let me remind you, he loves you. He weeps for you. He cares for us. Oh, may he give those tears in our eyes again. Blessed man as a tree planted by the rivers of water. I have come only to chapter 11. Chapter 12 you will find him in the feast. Or in the feast in the house in Bethany. Family have welcomed him and shown hospitality. Surely at the meal time there would have been water. For according to Jews' custom, they must have washed his feet. And there was water again to drink. In chapter 13, water is in the basin. And what a basin that was. God of all gods. He took really the humble position of a servant. They were arguing among themselves who is greatest. Nobody was ready to do the menial task. He rose up from the feast. He girded a towel. He took the basin. And he started washing their feet. And what a washing that was. That washing continued from chapter 13 to chapter 17. Not only in the upper room there, but as he walked with them, as he was walking through the gardens and the fields, he was talking to them precious things. He was encouraging their souls. He was washing them with the water of the word. It was then he spoke the most precious things. 13 to 17 are known as the upper room discourses of the Lord. Not all spoken in the upper room, but some on the way as they walked across. How much can I tell about chapter 14? Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go and prepare a place for you. And when I prepare, I'll come back again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you might be also. Chapter 15. Oh, the parable of the wine. Chapter 16. The great promises of the second comforter. Another comforter. The work of the Holy Spirit. In chapter 17, his intercessory prayer. When you come to chapter 18, read verse 1. You will find him near the brook Kidron. Again, there is a water. But these were the closing chapters and the closing days of the Lord Jesus. Time will not suffice me to speak more about this blessed man. For when he crossed through brook Kidron, something was waiting for him. Because when you come to chapter 19, you read verse 28 and verse 34, you find on the cross he is crying, I thirst. He who quenched everybody's thirst. He became thirsty for you. He became thirsty for us. Jesus Christ can cleanse all our sins. He can quench our thirst of soul. No man. No religion. Nothing of this world will save you from your sin. Jesus Christ died for your sin on the cross. He became thirsty there. Why did he become thirsty? Your position, my position should have been like that rich man in the Hades who said, put a drop of water on my tongue. That was your destination. That is the destination of every sinner. but Jesus Christ became sin for us on the cross. He took your sin. He took my sin. And the pain of that sin and the punishment of that sin was so much that he cried out, I thirst.
ആ പാപത്തിൻ്റെതായിട്ടുള്ളതായ വേദനയും പാപത്തിൻ്റെ ഭാരവും അതിൻ്റെതായ ന്യായവിധിയും അവൻ തന്നെത്താൻ ഏറ്റെടുത്തപ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് ദാഹിക്കുന്നു എന്ന് അവൻ കുരിശിൽ കരഞ്ഞു.
ഇഫ് യു സേ ടു ഹിം ടുഡേ,
ലോർഡ്,
ഐ എം എ സിന്നർ. Forgive my sins. I tried this religion, that religion. I tried so many ways of men. I'm frustrated, God. Now I come to you. I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. Your whole life will be transformed, brother.
അപ്പോൾ നിങ്ങളുടെ ജീവിതത്തിന് മാറ്റം വരും.
He became thirsty on the cross.
അവൻ കാൽവരി ക്രൂശിൽ അവൻ ദാഹമുള്ളവനായി.
They were not satisfied.
അവർ അവിടെ തൃപ്തരായില്ല.
The soldiers were there near the cross.
ആ പടയാളികളൊക്കെയും ആ ക്രൂശിന്റെ അരികെ തന്നെ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു.
One of them took his spear.
ആ ഒരു സ്പോഞ്ച് എടുത്ത്
and he pierced into his side.
ഒരു കുന്തം എടുത്ത് അവന്റെ വളകൾ കുത്തി.
And Bible says water and blood oozed out of his body.
രക്തവും വെള്ളവും അവിടുന്ന് ഒഴുകി എന്നാണ് ആ വേദപുസ്തകത്തിൽ വായിക്കുന്നത്.
Oh, what a price he paid for your sin and my sin.
എന്റെയും നിങ്ങളുടെയും പാപത്തിന് വേണ്ടി അവൻ എത്ര വലിയ വിലയാണ് കൊടുത്തത്.
Chapter 19 is so much we can speak about that precious water.
ആ വളരെ വിലയേറിയതായ വെള്ളത്തെക്കുറിച്ച് നമുക്ക് 19 അധ്യായത്തിൽ വളരെ പറയാനുണ്ട്.
But in chapter 20
അധ്യായത്തിൽ
you have again water into tears.
അവിടെ നമ്മൾ വെള്ളം കണ്ണുനീരായി കാണുന്നു.
But this time tear of Mary.
ആ ഇത് ഇപ്പോൾ മറിയയുടെ കണ്ണുനീരാണ്.
Disciples went off. But she stood there. Where is my Lord? She thought him to be a gardener. Tell me where they have taken him and I will go and take him back. Drop of Mary's tear. The Lord wiped it. And it's a beautiful expression only John writes. The Lord calling her with her delightful name, Mary. She cried out, Rabboni. She recognized. What a comfort it was. She is the only first woman who have had the first sight of the resurrected Lord. Don't stop there. As we close. In chapter 21. In verse 1 you will find him by the Sea of Tiberias. It's the same Sea of Galilee. But now it is called Sea of Tiberias. But the Lord was there. Why was he there? Because some of them said, he's gone. He's died. He's departed. Let us go back to our profession. He went there. But he took another 5 with him. 6 of them went. Deserting the Lord, forgetting all that he has done. They struggled the whole night. Did they catch anything? He went there. And he asked them, do you have any fish? They said, we have no fish. Without Lord God, you cannot be successful in your life. Cast your net on the right side. They did that. And how many fishes they caught? Only there it is recorded. In Luke 5, it is not recorded. Same incident repeated in John 21, it is recorded. Very precious lesson we learned there. John 21. 153 big fishes they caught. There is a beautiful secret there. But what do I see there? A believer who has gone wayward. Who has turned his back to the Lord. He has forgotten the ways of God. The Lord was there by the sea. He said to them. Earlier he said, come and see. Now he says, come and dine.
എന്നോട് കൂടെ വന്ന് ഭക്ഷണം കഴിക്കുക.
എവരിതിങ് വാസ് റെഡി ദേർ.
എല്ലാം അവിടെ തയ്യാറായിട്ടുണ്ട്.
ഐ ഓൾവേസ് സർപ്രൈസ് യു നോ.
ആ കുറച്ച് വാക്ക് ആശ്ചര്യപ്പെട്ടു
പോയി. അറ്റ് ദ സീ സൈഡ് ദേർ വാസ് ബ്രെഡ് ആൻഡ് ദേർ വാസ് fish broiled and kept ready remember he did not use their fishes
avare meen than upayogichilla ennu nam sadhikya
the fish and the bread was there
avada meenum appo avada undayirunnu
and he said come and dine
ningal kadannu vanna bhakshanam kazhikkuka ennu
I ask a question to myself
thannodu thanne chodichu
from where did that bread come
appo avada undanu vanna
fish is okay Maybe water is there. They got fishes. But how the bread came there? Did he not tempt him in his temptation? You are hungry. If you are son of God, command these stones to become bread. He could have done it easily. He did not do at his bidding. His bidding he cannot do. But for restoring a believer, I believe it was not difficult for the Lord to turn at the seashore the stones into bread. So Sami says, He is the blessed man. Look at his walk. Look at his standing. Look at his sitting. Look at his meditation. Look at his delights. He says he is like a tree. Planted by the rivers of water. The whole Gospel of John is full of water. I have just made an attempt to go through this. But each of this is actually 1 hour message for us. If you say you abide in him,
നിങ്ങൾ അവനിൽ വസിച്ചാൽ
ought to walk in the same way in which he walked
അവൻ നടന്നതുപോലെ നടക്കേണ്ടതാണ്
will you take the baton in your hand
അതിനുള്ളതായ കോല നിങ്ങൾ എടുത്ത് നിങ്ങൾ കയ്യിൽ വെക്കുമോ
beholding christ through john's eyes
ക്രിസ്തുവിനെ യോഹന്നാന്റെ കണ്ണുകളിലൂടെ കാണുക
a tree planted by the rivers of water
കാറ്റരികത്ത് നട്ടിരിക്കുന്നു
fruitful and abounding
വളരെയധികം ഫലം പുറപ്പെടുവിക്കുന്ന
may god make your christian life and my christian life fruitful and abounding
എന്റെയും നിങ്ങളുടെയും ക്രിസ്തു ജീവിതം കർത്താവ് ഫലവത്തമായി ഫലപുഷ്ടിയുള്ളതായി തീരുവാൻ തക്കവണ്ണം സഹായിക്കുക
യു വിൽ നോട്ട് ഫൈൻഡ് സച്ച് എ ലോർഡ് എനിവെയർ ഇൻ ദ വേൾഡ്
ഈ ലോകത്തിൽ ഒരു സ്ഥലത്തും ഇങ്ങനെ കർത്താവിനെ കാണാൻ
സച്ച് എ ലോർഡ് ഈസ് യുവർ ലോർഡ്
നിങ്ങളുടെ കർത്താവായിരിക്കുന്ന കർത്താവിനെ പോലെ
ലെറ്റ് അസ് ലവ് ഹിം ആൻഡ് സർവ് ഹിം
നമുക്ക് അവനെ സ്നേഹിക്കാം സേവിക്കാം
ലെറ്റ് അസ് വാക്ക് ഇൻ ദ വേ ദാറ്റ് ഹി വാക്ക്ഡ്
അവൻ നടന്ന വഴിയിൽ നമുക്ക് അവനെ പിന്തുടരാം
അൺടിൽ ഹി ലീഡ്സ് അസ്
അവൻ നമ്മെ
ടു അനദർ ഗാർഡൻ
മറ്റൊരു തോട്ടത്തിലേക്ക് നമ്മളെ കൊണ്ട് ആക്കുന്നത്
another river
മറ്റൊരു നദിയുടെ
another tree
മറ്റൊരു മരത്തിങ്കലേ
that's where you and I going to be
അവിടെയാണ് നാം എല്ലാം ആയിരിക്കുവാൻ
we are going to be part of all that
അതിനെ നാം ഒക്കെയും അതിനെ ഭാഗവാക്കളായി തീരും
brother a little life just small life
ചെറിയ വെളിച്ചം
stop frustrations
നമുക്കുണ്ടായ മറ്റു ചിന്തകളൊക്കെ വിടുക
stop all your own things
നമ്മുടെ സ്വന്തമായ കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ വിടുക
behold this blessed man And start following him. Your life will become a blessing. You will become a channel of blessing. May God bless his word to your heart and mind.
ഈ ദൈവവചനം കർത്താവ് നിങ്ങളുടെയും എന്റെയും ഹൃദയത്തിന് അനുഗ്രഹമാക്കി തീർക്കട്ടെ.